for today. We thank you for this beautiful nation of Saint Lucia. We bring before you these proceedings, the agencies, the people, the government. We ask for your blessing upon this ceremony to your honor and glory. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Amen. Again, folks, we ask you to please remain standing as we get ready for the playing of the national anthem, which will be done by pianist Shavi De Riviere. Thank you very much. And now, folks, you can all be seated. Good afternoon, everyone. Try that again. Good afternoon, everyone. That sounds much better. Launching of Taste of Saint Lucia Store, something I'm sure many of us cannot wait to experience. Please allow me to establish the protocol. Honorable Dr. Ernest Hilaire, Acting Prime Minister and Minister for Tourism, Investment, Creative Industries, Culture and Information. Honorable Emma Hippolyte, Minister for Commerce, Manufacturing, Business Development, Cooperatives and Consumer Affairs. Members of the Diplomatic Corps, Ms. Sunita Daniel, Chief Executive Officer of Export Saint Lucia, Ms. Yvonne Agard, Chairperson of the National Export Council, Ms. Sophia Alfie Henry, Permanent Secretary for the Ministry of Commerce, Manufacturing, Business Development, Cooperatives and Consumer Affairs, Ms. Donalyn Vitti, PF in the Tourism Ministry, Investment, Creative Industries, Culture and Information, Mr. Octavian Charles, Chief Executive Officer of Invest Saint Lucia, Mr. Tarius Antoine, Chairperson of the Saint Lucia Tourism Authority, Mr. McLeod Emmanuel, Chief Executive Officer of the Saint Lucia Citizenship by Investment Unit, Chairpersons and Board Members of Export Saint Lucia, Invest Saint Lucia, and the Saint Lucia Tourism Authority, Permanent Secretaries from the Ministries of the Government of Saint Lucia, specially invited guests, participants, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our ceremony here this afternoon. To officially warmly welcome us in, we have Ms. Sunita Daniel, the CEO of Export Saint Lucia, who will now present the introductory remarks. Ms. Daniel.
Thank you, Scotty. Good afternoon to everyone. I'm undecided on which is the greater joy I feel today, because I'm very joyous. Is it the realization of the Taste of St. Lucia store, or the smiles that I see on the faces of my clients to the back? Many, many of our clients, many manufacturers here today, and I know that they're very happy, and so are we at Export St. Lucia and Invest St. Lucia. I really want to thank all of you for coming here, and I believe that gratitude is one of the first things we must always express. And I know this is an introductory remark, but I'll give thanks, even though somebody else has to give even more thanks later on. I want to thank all of you here for your unwavering support, beginning with the support from the Government of St. Lucia through our parent ministry and our Minister of Commerce, Honorable Emma Hippolyte, and PS Sophia Alfie Henry. I would like to thank the Acting Prime Minister and Minister for Tourism, Honorable Ernest Hilaire, for the support of his ministry and the team at Invest St. Lucia and all the other agencies under Brand St. Lucia, which fall under his portfolio. His ministry has worked really closely with the Ministry of Commerce and especially with Export St. Lucia on the work that we have had to do in the past year. I must single out here a man who does not like the spotlight. I know he will turn red, but I will shine a light on him today. I want to thank Mr. Lyndon Arnold, who is the chairman of Invest Saint Lucia. Lyndon and I had a brief conversation, well, a conversation, and he said to me, Sunita, we'd really like to introduce a few more local offerings at the Pointe Seraphine complex. We don't think that we have enough of the local manufactured goods for our cruise visitors and for our locals to benefit from. So I said, okay, we had that discussion. I went to my board, and I want to thank the members of the board of the National Export Strategy. And I said to them, we have a great opportunity to be able to give a spot to our manufacturers and the clients of Export Saint Lucia. And without any hesitation, they agreed that we should go ahead and do that. I called Invest Saint Lucia. I called again on Mr. Arnold, and I said to him, well, we don't have any money, you know, the normal phrase. And he said to me, okay, we'll give you that property rent-free for a year. So I'm hoping that all of you manufacturers in the back can give them a round of applause first. And we can later lobby for us to have rent-free for another 5 or 6 years. And I see Minister Hile is opening his eyes. But many of us in the past have complained about not having the access to locally manufactured goods, that you have to go all over the place to get a gift that is locally manufactured. And we're so happy today that visitors and locals alike can come to one location and get everything that they need. And I also want to thank Invest Saint Lucia for the direction that they're going. And once again, thanks, Mr. Arnold, for the direction of your board. We've complained many times that Invest Saint Lucia is outward looking at outside investors and don't do too much for our internal investors. And we're so happy that we have 34 small investors here that Invest Saint Lucia has given that opening to. I also want to thank Mr. Erlan Labadi from Invest Saint Lucia for accommodating our efforts here. Erlan, I know we've been very troublesome. And we've tried to get this store open in less than a week, and you've been really, really great. So thank you for your assistance. Mr. Charles, the contractor, I've never seen a calmer man in my life. And if somebody had to come to me every minute and say, I want this change. Mr. Charles is okay. And I'd like to work with Mr. Charles again sometime. But thank you so much for remaining constantly calm under the pressure that we gave for the physical space. A special thanks to Ms. Delia Fassois, who has worked with us to ensure that this area looks as it does today and to ensure that the store opens today. The Taste of Saint Lucia was originally a campaign launched in the UK market. The project was funded by the International Trade Center, and it had two major components. The first involved the development of a marketing campaign and brand that sought to provide an umbrella label under which Saint Lucian products and services could be promoted to gain market share and presence within that market. The second component was to assist selected products and services to meet entry requirements to facilitate their market penetration. The Taste of Saint Lucia brand is a symbol of quality and authenticity. The development of this umbrella brand is in keeping with the direction of the Government of Saint Lucia under the Brand Saint Lucia agencies. Our aim is to afford locals and visitors the opportunity to purchase souvenirs and gifts that are actually 100% locally made. The shop will be full of character and very dynamic. It will be themed to reflect prevailing seasons and offer an unforgettable experience. Service exporters will be represented through ambience, mini presentations, and exhibitions of dance, music, and visual arts. We anticipate at least every quarter to bring in our clients. So the chocolate makers will come and show them how the chocolate is being made. Bring in our musicians to have shows. Bring in our ladies from the Choiseul craft market down in Choiseul to come up and show how they do their craft product. Bring in our writers, like I see Alice here, to have some reading days. So we anticipate having very frequently activities that will liven up the Pointe Seraphine complex also. The products and services on display We'll rotate. As you will appreciate that we could not fit all of our outstanding offerings in this space all at once. We could not take everybody. And that is one of the things that we were most sad about, not being able to accommodate everybody. But we will work out a schedule whereby we can get this done. Sustainability and growth will be the mantra of the shop and the brand. We are looking in the future to expand to other ports of entry. And who knows, I don't know what else Invest Saint Lucia is responsible for, but we may also look at opening Taste of Saint Lucia stores in international markets. Now trademarked in Saint Lucia and in the process of being trademarked in international markets, and I want to thank Mr. Thaddeus Antoine, who would have done that trademarking for us once again, free of charge. Thank you, Mr. Antoine. And we want to ensure that our IP and your IP is protected. The strength of the brand will carry less developed ones, while those which are already well developed and well established will add to its strength. So you know about the Chairman's brand, you know about the Baron's brand, you know about those big international brands. The smaller brands will benefit from that exposure, because if somebody comes in looking for that, they will be exposed to everything else that's in the store. I want to tell you that the testing of the brand has been quite successful, and you will hear testimonial to that effect later on. I just want to name our manufacturers by name. They've worked really hard. They're excellent business people. They've actually put together excellent products, and I'll just name some of those who will be in the store today. You will see Frances Rubb, Enchanted Kettle, St. Lucia Distillers, Illuminating Designs, Auntie Pearl, Rigodol Spice, ALM Publishing House, Lotus Cosmetics, Island Tea, Choiselle, Martelli Ocean Garden, Barons Limited, Lucia Swimwear, Belle Rouge, Opicon Farmers Association, Tikai Bouton, wearing their earrings as usual, Miku Chocolate Network, the Caribbean Craft Distilling, Miss Rose Confectionery, Rafferty Incorporated, Membet, Rainforest Foods, Kirk Elliott Photography, Vikings Trading Limited, Natmed, Choiselle Crafters, Koch Jewelry, Ron Paintings, Antilia Brewing Company, Sharon Turner Creative Solutions, Jaco Productions, Heineken St. Lucia with the Peter Bear and Peter Malt, Abby's Exotic Blends, and Caribbean Designs. So these are the first of what, and there are many, many of them. What's interesting for us and why this is so fulfilling for us is that we are aware that every single one of those 34 people would not be able to afford a space on their own. If we were to ask everybody to open your own store and do it on your own, they won't be able to do it. And we want to thank Invest Saint Lucia once again for offering that space rent-free for a short time, and to ensure that these people can have that space. We do know that we will cover all our overheads. We do know that we are all going to make it, because the feedback so far from hearing that the store is going to open has been tremendous from even our locals. So I want to thank you so much for being here. As we cut this ribbon to symbolize the commencement of business, we invite you to keep in mind that this is the tangible representation of the brand. What will ensure its success is the hard work, authenticity, and excellence that epitomizes exactly what we are selling to the world. Just a little taste of Saint Lucia. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Danielle. And folks, I'm very pleased to bring on our next presenter, a financial friend, clearly, of a taste of Saint Lucia, and that is Mr. Octavian Charles, the CEO of Invest Saint Lucia, that we have heard so much about.
Good afternoon. I would like to adopt the protocols already established. What struck me from the CEO's address was the diversity of the type of businesses that will be in that store. We're talking about agribusiness, manufacturing, photography, craft, brewing, food. And what that tells us is the level of entrepreneurship in our society, among our people, to ensure that they create their own employment as well as spurring the economy. Today, we join and congratulate our sister agency, Export Saint Lucia, on the grand opening of the Taste of Saint Lucia store. We also recognize and celebrate the local businesses that are part of the selected collection of premium food, beverage, and wellness products on display. Again, the CEO mentioned that not everybody could be accommodated, but I am sure that the mechanism can be worked out. You know, with the sister agencies like ourselves, to ensure that perhaps down the road we can look at maybe another store. Of course, not rent-free this time. While our two agencies may operate under different mandates, Invest Saint Lucia and Export Saint Lucia share a common focus, which is making direct contributions to our national economy. Export Saint Lucia endeavors to promote Saint Lucian products to consumers across the world. As you can see, this is a pot, and people from all nationalities do come to this pot. And Invest Saint Lucia seeks to stimulate and facilitate inward investments. Now, I am quite new to Invest Saint Lucia, but I have heard the criticism that we do it for the foreigners. Why don't you do it for the locals? So this is testimony to our contribution in helping, assisting the locals. The Taste of Saint Lucia store, therefore, truly represents a collaboration of two agencies under brand Saint Lucia. Sunita told you about her love story for our chairman. Invest Saint Lucia is pleased that our duty-free Pointe Seraphine shopping complex can provide a home for Taste of Saint Lucia. The shopping complex began in 1985 as the brainchild of the then National Development Corporation, and since then has served as an outlet for quality shopping and a social hub for patrons of our island. The complex houses one of the island's cruise ship terminals and is the largest of its kind in the Caribbean region, welcoming nearly 800 passenger arrivals annually. That was pre-pandemic. As the tourism industry rebounds, and it is rebounding, we expect to return to these levels, providing excellent visibility for the store and the opportunities for the local businesses exhibited. The principal role of Pointe Seraphine is to provide shopping for all your senses, and the Taste of Saint Lucia store will achieve this by offering visitors and locals the ultimate taste of our beloved island. Again, I want to thank the CEO and the team at Export Saint Lucia for ensuring that this occasion is taking place and to highlight the contribution of our local producers, our local manufacturers, our local entrepreneurs. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Charles from Invest Saint Lucia. Ladies and gentlemen, as we continue to share and we continue to celebrate in this momentous occasion for not only our producers but our entrepreneurs, many of who are young and budding, I would like to call on a minister who shares in the passion of ensuring that the entrepreneurs in St. Lucia, they get their big break. And to deliver the minister's address, I would like to call on the Honorable Emma Hippolyte, Minister for Commerce, Manufacturing, Business Development, Cooperatives, and Consumer Affairs.
Honorable Dr. Ernest Hillier, Prime Minister, Acting Prime Minister, and Minister for Tourism, Investment, Creative Industries, Culture, and Information, my permanent secretary, in the Ministry of Commerce, Mrs. Sophia Alfie Henry, permanent secretary, where's Vite? Permanent Secretary Vite in the Ministry of Tourism. We have Ms. Sunita Daniel, who's the Chief Executive Officer of Export Saint Lucia, and Ms. Yvonne Agard, Chairperson of the National Export Council. We have Mr. Thaddeus Atwan, Chairperson of the Saint Lucia Tourism Authority. We have Mr. Arnold, who is the chairperson of Invest Saint Lucia. We have Mr. Charles, who is the CEO. We have some leaders who are not here. We have officials, dignitaries from both central governments and quasi-government agencies, our manufacturers. We have here with us Mrs. Barbara Charles, who's the head of our small business development unit. And we have Mr. Esley Laffey, who is the head of our commerce and industry. And we have our deputy permanent secretary in the Ministry of Commerce here with us. Esteemed ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I know it's going to take something special like the opening of the Taste of St. Lucia store to pull me out of Soufre today. Today is my constituency day. So I had to be making apologies to my constituents and gave them a half day. But I know that the mission that we are on is one that is extremely important to us as a country. And I'm extremely pleased as well that among the persons and organizations who are going to showcase their products in that store are at least two of my groups from the women from Foshajak. So, and I'm seeing them here so they can understand that I'm representing them in another capacity this afternoon. It is indeed with great pleasure that I join all of you today for the opening of the Taste of St. Lucia shop here at Pointe Seraphine. The Taste of St. Lucia brand was created to represent and symbolize high quality products that are authentically St. Lucian. Now this brand has a physical home and makes it easier to access these wonderful products in a central location. I am extremely pleased and I want to add my word of thanks and gratitude to the board members of Invest Saint Lucia for facilitating this extremely important exercise. So let us show our appreciation to them. I am heartened to see the many brands stock here, and I understand that there are even more to come in the future. This emphasizes that what we already know at the Ministry of Commerce, that St. Lucia has a strong entrepreneurial sector with immense potential for expansion. And as I sat and listened to the names of the various persons exhibiting, it gave me great pleasure to appreciate that most of those small entrepreneurs started with our small business development unit, and most of them again got some strength through our Taiwan St. Lucia trade exhibition, and now the products have reached a point where, with the help of Export Saint Lucia in terms of the branding, that we can now put them on the shelf for export. So let us show our appreciation to the staff of the Small Business Development Unit, as well as the government of Taiwan, who has a representative here with us. I want to take this moment to congratulate each and every producer who has answered Export Saint Lucia's call and can now confidently state that their product is on yet another shelf. This Taste of Saint Lucia shop is an opportunity for you to build your name and your brand and to have your product enjoyed by hundreds, if not thousands, of our new customers. I hope, as a small business, you truly understand the value of this new journey that you have embarked on with Export Saint Lucia as your guide. A function of the Ministry of Commerce is to work with the private sector to establish a dynamic investment and trade environment. We do so by providing information and support services that take your business from an idea to a reality. The Ministry of Commerce will soon provide loans and grant assistance through our Small Business Development Center, and I encourage all of you entrepreneurs here today to contact the ministry for more information. Additionally, the Ministry of Commerce and its affiliate agencies like Export Saint Lucia and the Bureau of Standards are regularly innovating and conceptualizing new opportunities that will breathe new life into the way we think about trade. The Taste of Saint Lucia shop is the latest in a diverse portfolio. Some of you here are already established exporters. For others, you will soon have the opportunity to call yourself an exporter as well, as visitors are expected to purchase your product and take them home to their friends and families. The staff at Export Saint Lucia can assure you that this too is considered an export. As I mentioned before, this shop is situated at an ideal location and can be accessed by your long-standing customers while serving as an introduction of your brand to new clients. Those of us gathered here have the distinct privilege of making the first purchases at this store and supporting small business in the most impactful way. So I really hope that we have walked with our credit cards and our checkbooks when we tour the store later. You will observe for yourself the number of brands that are already under the Taste of Saint Lucia shop. I have been assured by the CEO of Export Saint Lucia that other brands will be introduced in the coming months. I look forward to the expansion of the product offerings and the recognition of this shop across Saint Lucia. It is my expectation that visitors will be aware of this shop even before landing on our beautiful island. The Taste of Saint Lucia store is an investment in our Saint Lucian enterprises. It is a new opportunity for you to earn a living, see what products are favored, and even expand your own offerings. I implore the team at Export Saint Lucia to continue to support Saint Lucian enterprises and to work with new upcoming producers to get their goods in the Taste of Saint Lucia's shop as well. I urge all Saint Lucians to champion what is authentically ours and enjoy a taste of Saint Lucia. I congratulate everyone who has been involved and pledge my government's commitment to put you, our business owners, first and support the expansion of our local economy. May God guide us on this journey. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Madam Minister. Folks, we've heard the number of brands that threw their support behind Taste of Saint Lucia, and that was via our introductory addressed by the CEO of Export Saint Lucia, Ms. Sunita Daniel. Now we are going to hear from one of them firsthand, as we have one of our first testimonials for the afternoon, and it will be delivered by Saint Lucia Distillers, and I think I see Surgeon here who will be delivering that testimonial. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Saint Lucia Distillers to the podium.
Adopting the protocol that has already been established, good afternoon, everyone, and it is indeed a pleasure to be a representative of one of the local manufacturers that are going to be highlighted in this physical brick-and-mortar store where our sister producers and artisans will also have an opportunity to have their products on display and on sale. For us at St. Lucia Distillers, we've always made it a priority. It's actually engraved as one of our pillars to ensure that the products that we make is not only just a product, but a taste, an actual taste of St. Lucia, because we always sell St. Lucia first. So in the initial stages of when this initiative came about, and Glenfield was actually my contact on that, there was a lot of back and forth when we started to think of what the logo is gonna look like. For us, we thought it was a fantastic opportunity because Saint Lucia is ours. What we produce within Saint Lucia is important not only to when we sell it outside our shores, but to us as a people. And being one of the established exporters, part of this initiative, for us, lending our support, ensuring that our brand is there to show support and to give the opportunity to other persons coming up to have that highlight is important to us. Saint Lucia is ours. And for us, when the first phase, one of the first phases of having the neck tags come about, to have that more identifiable mark with all the different other manufacturers and products that were on the shelves in the major supermarkets here in Saint Lucia, that worked out extremely well for us. We do well on the international market. We do well on the local market as well. But I could tell you, just by having that initiative of the neckties added on to our products on the shelf, added an additional boost, upward boost in sales. And you know, that's always worked well for an organization, right? It helps on the bottom line of things. So having this second phase be brought forward is something that needs to be applauded, something that needs to be thanked by, you know, I'll take this opportunity from a manufacturing standpoint and for some of my other partners who are going to be a part of this store to say thank you. Thank you for giving Saint Lucian products a home. Thank you for bringing all of us together in one location rather than we try and get ourselves in other, you know, other shops, especially at Pointe Seraphine. Thank you for us having a home. It is a Saint Lucian home for us. So we want to say thank you for that. And I want to speak to every person who's, or every manufacturer who's actually going to have an opportunity, or producer or artisan who's going to have their products visible in that store so that we can actually have, you know, some sort of economical benefit for you. Keep your product level always at its utmost best. You're not representing your brand, you're representing Saint Lucia. So that is something that I hope that you take with you. And, you know, again, thank you.
Thank you very much, Surgeon. Of course, we would all know that Saint Lucia Distillers is indeed one brand that is passionate about the local product, from helping out the promoters to the shop owners. We always see the brand Saint Lucia Distillers wherever we go, so much so that in New York right now, we've been asked to bring shipments when we fly. Folks, at this time, I would like to just take a break from the remarks and bring on a gentleman that I have had the pleasure of sharing the stage with once upon a time. Now he has gone on his own and he's going solo. He has been traveling the world over, recently from his store in Dubai, I believe. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for violinist Yannick James. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Yannick James, please give him another round of applause. He reminded me that he did not only tour Dubai, but he also had his French tour as well. Give him a round of applause for that. Folks, we're about to bring on an individual who, as of late, I have been indulging in something that he will be telling us about, and that is having tea. Especially when you have a team on top of the league, you invite your friends over for a spot of tea. To give us a testimonial this afternoon, please welcome Mr. Matthew Anderson from the Enchanted Kettle.
Good afternoon. This music, Abagoj, has befitting to a king. I'm not saying I'm a king, but that's a good entry. I want to say special thanks to the creator of the universe for this wonderful weather today in this wonderful setting. I mean, you know, give thanks. You know, there is, first of all, I want to give special thanks to Mistress Marcian Lloyd Justin, who is my brand manager sitting right over here, of which whose hard work we have been here at this level of success. Thanks to you, Miss Justin. And another person who's not here is my partner, Manny Ambrose. You know, through many sleepless nights, for us to get where we are today, we had to do it together. Unfortunately, she couldn't make it. She's taking care of business, you know, the Enchanted business. But enough big up to Miss Manny Ambrose, my partner in this business. My name is Matthew Anderson, and like I said, I'm a part owner, Miss Ambrose as well, and the creator of the Enchanted Kettle. The Enchanted Kettle is an innovative food and beverage company. And what we seek to do is harness the potential of tropical plants and blossoms. You know the ones, the bush? Yeah, we're harnessing that to make available health and wellness products for the life of everyone with the ease of bring a cup of tea. Brewing, something we forget. We always, now we just blend it, right? Blender, but we can brew. This greenery we are seeing here is not bush, it's wealth, right? Your wealth is what you have in abundance. We say the wealth of knowledge. But what the wealth of wellness is right here. We are forgetting, we are paying attention to the flashing lights. I just want to say it here. With the taste of Saint Lucia, the company commenced its operation 6 years ago as an experiment, in an experimental stage, and was officially launched on June 28th, 2016 at Cap Maison. And Cap Maison, mentioning Cap Maison, I want to give special thanks to Ross Stevenson. The day when I presented that bush tea, you know, he gave it double thumbs up, and he decided he was going to make it the house tea. Boaden, right? That's what we call it, bay tea. But it has an official name, Resamosa. We can always look it up. It's an awesome product that we have ignored again. Special thanks to Ross, you know, for all his support and ongoing support. We sell organic teas made from herbs and spices and blossoms. Now we have flowers here, but the bees love it and they convert it to honey, but we don't think about how can we use it. What is it? Flowers, you know what I mean? Yeah, it's food, you know? Medicine is food. We decided to go into the tea business as we see the potential for teas to encourage our local people to pay attention to their health and wellness for the consumption of teas. And again, the word tea, you know, is from a special leaf down in China, but we say teas. But these are herbal elements, right? And we call it tea, but you can brew it into an ice beverage as well. You can enjoy it either way. Export Saint Lucia has been a driving force behind our company, assisting us and encouraging us. Our decision to work with Export Saint Lucia stemmed from the fact that we believe it is necessary to showcase our island by showing what our people have to offer, not just the sun and the sea. We know it's there. And also, one of the goals of Export Saint Lucia is also that, to get it out there. Today is a testimony of that. They have made it available in this location, not only for the foreigners, but for everybody that's here to come into Pointe Seraphine, which is a place people just assume is for tourists. Today, I say to all the locals, come here and get all the wellness. We have benefited from the partnership through the knowledge, the training, the courses that we have attended. They have always made things available for us to be able to learn how to manage our business and so on. And they purchase our teas when they're pushing out to foreign markets to bring it out there for people to, you know, indulge. So special thanks again to Export Saint Lucia, right, for today and for all the team, the members of the team that have worked with us relentlessly to make this happen. For products to be recognized as a good enough to be part of the Taste of Saint Lucia brand, it brings us much joy, right? This is awesome. We're excited to be part of this initiative, as this would mean bringing our product into more households. Not only can our local people enjoy the teas, but they can share it with their friends and families all over the world, the diaspora. Send the burden to them, you know. Low and jet, them kind of things. It's good for you. COVID remind us we had to take it, you know. Encouraging our people to be healthy and to consume our local benefits is our mandate. That's our mandate, to get people to get healthy, affordable foods. In closing, the Enchanted Kettle is thankful for the Export Saint Lucia for the opportunity to express. We're expressing gratitude and joy for a joyful heart. We look forward to continue in this prosperous relationship. Well done, Export Saint Lucia. Keep encouraging our people to buy local and to showcase local. Give thanks.
Thank you very much, Mr. Anderson. And like he said, folks, always support, always buy local. We're going to bring on an individual who is synonymous with ensuring that we all follow that mantra, which is buy local, support local. And he will be delivering the second minister's address for the afternoon. Please welcome to the podium the Honorable Dr. Ernest Tiller, Acting Prime Minister, Minister for Tourism, Investment, Creative Industries, Culture, and Information, to deliver our second minister's address.
Thank you very much, Master of Ceremony, colleague Minister Honorable Emma Hippolyte, Minister of Commerce, Manufacturing, Business Development, Cooperatives and Consumer Affairs, Permanent Secretaries, Chairpersons of various boards, CEO of various statutory corporations, Ms. Sunita Daniel, CEO of Export Saint Lucia, manufacturers, special invited guests, good afternoon. I think I'm sitting here and I'm listening to the presentations, the testimonials, and I really want to join Sunita in her feeling of joy and happiness at what we're doing this afternoon. And I really want you to reflect on just how significant is the achievement of this afternoon. And as I said, I was wondering, why had this not been done before? I mean, I'm listening to it, I'm understanding its importance, and I could not seem to figure out why it had not been achieved before. But even before that, I heard the Sunita and then the CEO of Invest Saint Lucia. Earlier today, we were at a meeting, and in the course of our meeting, it came up that Invest Saint Lucia has had to waive about $6 million worth of revenue from Pointe Seraphine because of COVID and the tenants not being able to meet their rental fees. So $6 million has been waived in rental income that is owed to Invest Saint Lucia. And then I heard that they gave away the office, the store space for 1 year rent-free. The very same day I told the CEO, no more freeness for anybody. And then to hear that they will lobby to get it for an extended period of 5 years. So, I mean, you can imagine my fright at where we're heading. But I think despite all of that, you have to admit that this is a fantastic idea. It really captures the essence of what we want to achieve in St. Lucia. And that is to encourage our people to invest through their time, their energy, their knowledge, their skills, their competencies in producing items that we need in St. Lucia, both for our local consumption as well as for export. And for us in the Ministry of Tourism, the DPS is here and the PS, they will all tell you that we believe very deeply that we must work to have a tourism industry where there are less leakages and more linkages, that less of the tourist dollar goes back out, less imports are made to service the tourism industry. And for us to achieve that, we must produce more. We must encourage our people to meet the demands of our local populace and the tourism sector in particular. I think you all know from a simple understanding of economics that economies grow when you export. If you don't export, you cannot grow. You have to export. Either you export goods or you export services. And in this case, the future of St. Lucia, the very economic viability of St. Lucia rests upon the successes of the manufacturers around, in fact, gathered here today, and the efforts of Export Saint Lucia. We must transform our economy into an export-oriented economy. So we export the tourism services, we export financial services, but we also export goods. And this is a fantastic addition to that. I must say to Minister Hippolyte and the team at Export Saint Lucia, both the board of directors and the staff, that you all have been doing a fantastic job. I must tell you that. I'm really proud to be associated with the work that has been done. I was in Dubai with the team when we attended earlier this year, and you saw the reaction to St. Lucia's exhibition room. You saw the vibe it had about it. You felt the energy of the team. And I know from working with Export St. Lucia that it is a tremendous amount of work and dedication to what they're doing. And I really want to congratulate you and ask you to continue to do the great work that you're doing. We just came from another promotion in MENA, in the Middle East and North Africa, with CIP. And we have plans for, you know, the Middle East again to promote. And I visited a store, and basically a lot of condiments, peppers and spices, whatnot. And the guy was explaining to me, there are so many more workers than there are actually Emiratis and foreigners living and working. And that's a tremendous resource that nobody really thinks about how we can satisfy their needs. They want peppers, they want sauces, they want a lot of what we produce in St. Lucia. Now somebody will say, this place is way too far. How are we gonna get stuff to go to the Middle East? And then I read of the successes of Export Saint Lucia in sending CMOS to Dubai. I mean, the joke is that when they put the CMOS on this place, it had to be sold. Somebody spread a rumor in Dubai that it actually helps. I can't tell you how it helps, but it helps. And then you had Emiratis lining up outside the Saint Lucia Pavilion wanting to buy our CMOS. And I mean, it was virtually sold out in just about a day or so. And I think recently they just sent a 40-foot container of more help to Dubai. So, I mean, you know, the simple point I'm trying to make is that, you know, we went out there, the team did very well, Export Saint Lucia did very well, and they've created a new opportunity. Our biggest challenge might be whether we can even meet the demand. And of course, the logistics of distance and everything else that comes with that. But there are tremendous potentials around the world. There's a lot that we can achieve. And I'm really glad and supportive of this initiative. I think it will help our whole campaign about encouraging solutions to participate more, to own more of our productive capacity in this country. We cannot always rely on the foreign interests, the foreign investors, to come to our country to do it. And very soon, the Ministry of Tourism will be piloting a new Tourism Development Act. And premise on that new act and the offering of incentives and concessions is about favoring our local people. We're not saying others do not deserve concessions, incentives. That will always be there. But we must create an enabling environment where our own St. Lucians can get the support, the encouragement for them to thrive and for them to prosper in their own country. And that will always be a driving force for us. Pointe Seraphine, as you were told, is an ideal location for such, because it really is the point at which both locals and visitors meet, coming in from the cruise ships, from the hotels, as well as our locals do come here to look, especially in the season that's coming up for Christmas. You know, I don't come to shop, but I mean, I hear of all those who do come there to shop and buy all their stuff. So it's the right place. It will expose our local manufacturers. So I'm excited about the choice of Pointe Seraphine. I do hope you have the successes, and I know you will, where you'll be given a second shop. And this time, of course, you will pay for it because you'll be making enough money to pay for it. But to the manufacturers, I really want to encourage you. I'm really proud whenever I see the successes of our local manufacturers, our local entrepreneurs, and it really gives you a very happy feeling that we are, as a nation, reaching our potential and achieving things that are really necessary to drive this country. So, congratulations, Sunita, team, Minister Hippolyte, and everyone who's associated with the Taste of St. Lucia initiative and the opening of the shop. I didn't carry my wallet with me, so I trust you will be giving credit, or maybe some of my friends will pay for whatever I choose on the shelves this afternoon. Maybe Minister Hippolyte, she has a big bag there, so I'm sure she came from her constituency, so I know she have a few dollars in her bag. So thank you very much, congratulations, and best wishes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Minister. I mean, after you just tell the people no more freeness, you come and say you want credit. And worse, he bring all his friends in it too, you know. Well, Minister, she just came from down the road, and all my friends, that is not of an Arsenal fan. Ladies and gentlemen, we have another musical rendition for you this afternoon. I am very pleased to bring on this young man. I call him a viral sensation because he has truly revolutionized the way we listen to steel pan music and appreciate it. Please put your hands together for the great one, Chaz. Thank you. changed the way we listen to. We realized everybody had to watch what he was doing. It's no longer just listening to jazz
play pan. You have to watch all what he's doing. Sometimes my pan stick might go all over there and come right back to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are quickly approaching the end of our short ceremony. And now I would like to call on Mr. Glenn Gilbert to deliver the thank you remarks.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I wish to adopt the protocol that has already been established and to, you know, beat my chest a bit. I got some woos. I didn't hear that for any of the ministers, even my CEO. Okay. Sorry. I'd like to echo, the sentiments of the speakers who were preceded me on just what this new venture symbolizes. The new opportunities for the manufacturers and service providers, the potential of an added revenue stream in what continues to be challenging economic times. We'd like to thank you for your presence and continued support, Acting Prime Minister and Minister for Commerce, Tourism, Dr. Ernest Hilaire, Minister for Commerce, Honorable Emma Hippolyte, Permanent Secretaries of the Government Ministries, Chairperson of the National Export Council, Ms. Yvonne Agard, Chairman of Invest Saint Lucia, Mr. Lyndon Arnold, CEO of Invest Saint Lucia, Mr. Octavian Charles, Manager of Pointe Seraphine Duty Free Shopping Complex, Mr. Erlen Labadi, and I would like to add here that I've beaten Erlen in basketball many, many times. Also, the team from Export Saint Lucia has beaten the team from Invest Saint Lucia many, many times. And we've even put Mr. Labadi and Mr. Dave Headley from Invest Saint Lucia into retirement. So whenever you're ready, we game. The Bishop, Dr. Emmanuel McLaurin, manufacturers, clients of Export Saint Lucia, our interior designer and project supervisor, Dahlia Francois, contractor, Mr. Charles, the staff of Export Saint Lucia and Invest Saint Lucia for all the support. All of this would not have been possible without you, and as such, we, the staff of Export Saint Lucia, the manufacturers and other stakeholders are thankful. Support from our government has never wavered. We have always gotten advice and policy direction, and have also been called upon when critical decisions that had to be made regarding our mandate was sought. Our manufacturers and service providers are always ready to jump on board with all of our initiatives. They continue to work with us while we continue to work for them. A special thank you to the International Trade Center that was instrumental in the development of the Taste of Saint Lucia brand. Thank you all, our invited guests. Thank you, members of the media, for your usual kind support. Thank you, the management and staff of Pointe Seraphine. Without your commitment, this would not have been possible. Thank you as well, Mr. Master of Ceremonies, and over to you, sir. Thank you.
I really don't know why he brought the whole sporting aspect into it. You get your woos, you were happy, and you just start a war with basketball. Glenn, you know better than that. Thank goodness the next part of the agenda is a blessing. Folks, we are going to ask everyone now to proceed to the store. And we're going to start with our first two rules, and after they've exited, then everyone can follow. We are going to have the blessing by Bishop Dr. Emmanuel McLaurin, and then we have the cutting of the ribbon, which will be followed by a walkthrough around the store. After, we can all come here, except Glenn, he's on punishment for refreshments. Thank you all, and welcome to the official Taste of Saint Lucia store.
Open your eyes. You won't find me in a place where I always knew I belong. Open your heart. find me in a paradise for so blessed to go home. She's just so magical and cynic. She's so bountiful and pure. A light that illuminates your spirit. A gem you can't ignore. Watch the sunrise of your twin peaks. Watch the sunset at your shores. If the oceans could tell stories, then the waves would sing your song. Wake up with a smile, cause I'm just so happy. Happy for the life that your light embodies. Say there's no place like home. We can catch a vibe over hills and valleys. Keep a selfish with a finger in a shoe. Down by the river where the kids clothes wash you. Say there's no place like home. The sun could set me free. Your love is all I need. Only one journey. Our future is so bright.
Jesus Christ. Thank you that every good and perfect gift comes from you, Lord. You have promised in your word that if we commit whatever we do to you, then you will cause our plans to succeed. As we align our plans with your will, let those who manage this business hear your voice clearly as you give wisdom and guidance to them. Please give the leaders strength that they need to succeed in this business. Lord, bless this work and this business with prosperity for good and for your glory. All knowing God, thank you that you make known your love, that your purpose will stand, your plans will not fail. Your word says that the blessings of the Lord brings wealth without painful toil for it. Protect the business from going down the path of painful toil for no benefit. Bring success to the business. Let these products that are part of this Taste of Saint Lucia be at a high quality brand that keeps people locally, regionally, and internationally keep coming back for more. We ask may the demands for these goods infuse economical growth in many sectors as we purposefully maintain a high quality product that is second to none in the world. So in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we bind every sabotaging, undermining attitude, behaviors, and sinister forces at work that will seek to hinder the growth of this economical venture. Hear our prayer, Lord. You are able to do more abundantly than all that I ask or imagine. According to the power that works within, to you be glory and through all generations forever and ever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And so, our Father, I now pronounce and decree divine blessings on the taste of St. Lucia, on the store and the entire sector. We declare in the name of your Son, Jesus, that your hands will be upon this business. Your face will shine upon this business. And favor, we declare favor upon this business, even now, in Jesus' name. And everybody say,
Amen.
That's what you did.